So, what is Fusion 360? Is it for engineers? Yes. Is it for 3D designers? Yes. Is it for electronic designers? Yes. Or is it for manufacturers? Yeah. Well, Fusion 360 is for all of us. It contains 7 different workspaces inside of it. Design workspace, generative design, render, animation, simulation, manufacture, technical drawing, and plus electronic design. Whoa, easy. In this video, I'm gonna explain all workspaces while showing you real examples in Fusion 360. Before diving into the video, don't forget to subscribe to Designwagoon channel and click the ring button. Let's get started. Hi, this is Cengiz from Designwagoon channel. In this tutorial, we're going to explain exactly what Fusion 360 is. What can you design in the software? Well, actually, it's not just designing software. First of all, Autodesk Fusion 360 is a cloud-based 3D design, engineering, and manufacturing software. Basically, I can say that it's a software that manages the whole process from the concept of the product to its manufacture. Well, everything starts with the design workspace. What can you design in this default workspace? You can basically use all of CAD's computer-aided design tools on the solid modeling tab. Also, you can use organic modeling tool as form. You'll have a chance to play with T-sublines to create organic models. And the important thing is that all proper form models will convert automatically to solid models. Plus, in the same workspace, you can design surfaces and sheet metals, which are quite common techniques in lots of industries. And if you're a 3D printing enthusiast like me, after you download and upload your 3D models to Fusion 360, you can use mesh tools to modify the specific components. Let's continue with render workspace. Sometimes you could spend hours or days to model something you want, but in general, it's not enough to present your 3D model to a jury of university, clients, managers, or let's keep it short, to people. So, render workspace is our helper to present our 3D models like photorealistic images. You can easily assign appearances to your components. Then, there are several parameters that help you obtain photorealistic render. My favorite thing is in the render workspace is that you can work in cloud. For example, this panel wall clock is normally rendered around 6 hours on another render motor. But I rendered this image around 20 minutes and thanks to cloud-based render on Fusion 360. For a large-scale projects or product promotion, we always want to promote our design in a fancy and sparkly way. Well, animation workspace exactly does that. Make a quick camera animation on your scene, use the power of auto-explode tool, or change the visibility of some components. It's all about timing, and you'll have a chance to try an animation timeline to make a unique video. As always, I promised, I have a quick tip for you. In design workspace, there is a motion study tool that allows creating animation with respect to your joints on the project. If you are a mechanical engineer or if you are a member of similar engineering discipline, you already know how important to analyze your projects before you start to produce. Now, if you are thinking to produce something you design, well, you better call Saul. No, it was for something else. You better learn how to use the simulation workspace. For now, there are 10 different types of analysis are available on Fusion 360. You can analyze the deformation and stress into the model from structural loads and constraints. Well, I definitely prefer to use static stress analysis before starting to manufacture our project components. Shape optimization or topology optimization is a widely used study type that optimizes parts to make them lightweight and structurally efficient based on the conditions you prefer. I'm not diving into all analysis types in this video, but if you'd like to learn deeply these analysis tools, please let us know in the comments below. Well, we are still in the same software. Now it's time to reveal manufacturing workspace capabilities. If you want to produce a little tiny part or mass production for large-scale projects, you need to generate machine codes that bring your design to reality. It calls G-code in different types of manufacturing techniques. So, what types of manufacturing are available on Fusion 360? 2-5 axis milling, turning and mill turn, water jet, plasma, or laser cutting. And the next one is my favorite, 3D printing additive. You'll have a chance to create your own G-code, which is suitable for your manufacturing machine. I can easily say that you can always encounter some issues in converting your design part format to another software for manufacture or analysis. But Fusion 360 has all the necessary workspaces to bring your projects to reality as soon as possible. As we mentioned the importance of manufacturing in the previous section, technical drawing is well-known and useful equipment to make a bridge between manufacturers and engineers. You'll have lots of tools to create understandable technical drawings, and if you change anything on your recent design parts, the drawing will be up to date after you permit. Also, you can export your technical drawing in PDF, DVG, and DXF format, which are handy to use at the industry level. I think if you are an electronic engineer, a member of a similar engineering discipline, or an electronic project maker, you'll love the 3D PCB design tool in Fusion 360. You can create the next evolution of product with a unified schematic, PCB, library management, simulation, and mechanical design in the Fusion 360 3D PCB workspace. Your PCB data at the same time is your mechanical data. So cool, right? For me, as a mechanical engineer, in some of our projects, we used the 3D PCB workspace in the team. It was totally full connected with engineering teams. It was quick. It was reliable with data formats, up to date between teams on the project. Well, my favorite workspace, generative design.
All right. Yeah.
In a short definition, generative design is a design exploration process. Designers or engineers input design goals into the generative design software along with parameters such as performance or special requirements, materials, manufacturing methods, and cost constraints. The software explores all the possible permutation of a solution, quickly generating design alternatives. It tests and learns from each iteration what works and what doesn't. I will share a new video about completely how generative design works and what can you design with generative design. Well, for a quick preview for the next video, this is our outcome for a robotic arm gripper holder, which is designed by generative design algorithm. And this is the 3D printed part that is produced by PCBWay.com. You can get more information from the video that I added to the end screen. Well, I hope the 8 different workspaces of Fusion 360 will help with your projects. And I have a question for you. Which workspace is your favorite in Fusion 360? Please just drop a comment below and let us know about your thoughts. We are also creating interesting videos on Instagram Designwagoon channel. You can also find the link below. If you'd like to see more tutorials about Fusion 360 and designing, subscribe to Designwagoon channel on YouTube. Hope to see you next tutorials.